Greetings, I'm Chameleon, I make AI-related videos. Today I'm gonna demonstrate some of the speech-to-speech voice transformation models that I've trained over time. Some of these are gonna be better than others, and that's mostly because of the quality of the input. I'm using Sovitz SVC Fork to do all this. I am familiar with RVBC Web UI, but I can't get that to work on my machine. I have an AMD card. Hopefully someday I'll be able to switch to that because it seems like a better user interface. But Sovitz SVC Fork is pretty good anyway. So let's get right into it. I'm going to explain the model, explain how I trained it, and give you a little litmus test in the form of this clip right here. This first one is Commander Shepard from Mass Effect. It's a pretty good model. I like it because as long as you stay inside of its natural range, it sounds pretty close to the original. Takes a little bit of tweaking of the pitch to match your voice, but it's pretty good. It doesn't seem to be great on singing, but it's good for natural voice speaking. I trained this on over 4 hours of isolated voice clips straight from the video game, thanks to EvilBanana202, who does a bunch of these kinds of uploads. Using these rips from him can be a little bit of a problem with Sovitz SVC, because there is a pre-split portion of the training where it splits the audio into little chunks that can be processed. And if those chunks are too big, you'll have to split them out yourself manually, because if you have an isolated voice chunk that is way too long, you're going to run out of VRAM when you're actually doing the pre-Hubert step. The problem with these isolated voice lines is that there's no silence in between the clips, so the automated clipper in Sovitz SVC Fork can't detect breaks between the speech, so it can give you long clips up to 15 minutes sometimes, and you need to really get it down into maybe under 2 minutes, depending on how much VRAM you have. So that's it for that model. Might as well play the Scatman clip just for reference. This is particularly bad at doing songs, so consider yourself warned if you want to make Shepard sing really anything that has a lot of range.
And while we are on the topic of Mass Effect, I've got one that I was pleasantly surprised with, and that's Tali. The source for Tali is the same guy, EvilBanana202, and it's from 1.5 hours of voice samples. I think it's pretty good. I didn't expect it to be any good because of the voice modulation, but here it is. I trained it up to 320 epochs, seems to be enough for me. And you'll just end it on the Scatman clip for reference.
Okay, moving on, I've got HAL 9000 from 2001, A Space Odyssey. This one is, very limited. It was trained straight from the movie. I painstakingly isolated all of HAL's voice clips, which there was not a lot of lines overall, not a lot of minutes to go on. But it passes. Since HAL's a robot anyway, imperfections are overlooked usually. You have to kind of do a HAL impression to make it convincing, which I'm not doing right now. I'm just speaking normally. But, I did a couple of videos on using the HAL voice. It seems to, you know, kind of work for that. He's very quiet is the main problem with this model. And, of course, he doesn't have any range at all. He speaks very flatly in the movie, so that comes across here in the model as well. So, HAL was trained up to 800 epochs. And that's all I'd say about it. Here's the Scatman clip for reference.
Let's move on to Lord of the Rings. I've got Galadriel here. It's somewhat limited of a model. I'm not that pleased with it. It kind of sounds like Galadriel, but if you listen to it next to actual clips of her, it's obvious that there's something missing there. I'm not quite sure what. She speaks very clearly in the movies, and this model came out a bit fuzzy. It was trained on all of Galadriel's voice lines from the movie. It was a little bit easier than HAL 9000 because she mostly speaks in monologues throughout the movie, so it wasn't that bad to get enough minutes of her source material. But as you can see, compared to something that has a lot of high-quality, isolated voice clips like Commander Shepard, this one is not quite as good. I trained this one up to 1,600 epochs, and I'll leave you with the Scatman clip for reference.
And even worse than Galadriel is Gimli. It really does not sound like Gimli at all. I'm very displeased with this model. Although I suppose I'm not that surprised. I started by painstakingly clipping all of the Gimli lines that were clean enough in the movie. He kind of talks a lot with other things underneath him, like other voices in the background, so it's hard to get enough isolated audio, so I also had to resort to clipping Jean-Rhys Davies. He has a few YouTube uploads that helped out, so I put that into the mix. He's just monologues for a few minutes in his videos. That's probably why it doesn't sound very Gimli-like. It's a 2020 Jean-Rhys Davies instead of 2001 for most of the samples, and the samples aren't even that clean to begin with. So he was trained to 1,200 epochs, and without further ado, Scatman.
Okay, let's move on to VTubers. If you're just getting into training with this stuff, VTubers are easy mode. They often have streams that are hours and hours, where they talk by themselves with just some light background music. And it's a piece of cake to remove that BGM with Ultimate Vocal Remover, and then you're on your way to training. Another thing I like about VTubers is they tend to have a lot of range when they do their speaking, because they'll do kind of wacky voices and stuff, and so the more range that the input has, the better you're gonna end up with as the final result. This one, of course, is Pipkin Peppa, trained to 300 epochs. A couple of things to note that are interesting about this. One, the kind of stuffiness that's in her voice comes across here, as well as her habit of speaking directly into the microphone and kind of blowing it out a little bit. So that comes across in this model, too. But this one's actually really good for singing, because of the samples that I have high range, and use this Catman for example.
And here we have my personal favorite model so far, Tamu Rainpuff. This one's my favorite just because of the extremely high quality of input that it has. She's got a professional microphone set up, she's got the volume just right, she's got clean samples, and she talks with a lot of range. She talks very clearly, and there's just, I can't say enough good things about how high quality her input samples are. So, very good one for singing. And really anything you want to throw at this model, it can take it. I trained this one up to about 600 epochs. And, here's the scat man.
And just for fun, here's Pongwin Puff as Frogbert from a specific stream that she did. I just wanted to see if it would be any different. And actually, it is that kind of Kermit the Frog impression that she's doing, it comes across in the model here. Not much to say about this one other than it works. I trained this up to 200 epics. Here's Batman.
Well, that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching. I do have a lot more models that I've trained of various quality, but the video's already 10 minutes, so didn't want to bore you with all these just random things, but I did want to show you just kind of the three different categories of obtaining input. One from video game rips, two from directly from movies and such, and then three from just a natural talking stream like a VTuber would do. If you have any questions on how to do this technically, just drop a comment and I'll see what I can answer. Thanks again, and I'll leave you with this outro.
I can sing whatever you want, baby gal. Snake Eater.
What a thrill. With darkness and silence to the night. What a thrill. I'm searching and I'll melt into you. When I feel in my heart, when you're so surprised.